fatura, drive fiscal, unless napa-service mo yan, every na-service mo na yan. So, you are now about to leave the gasoline station. And then you look at the gasoline gauge. It's pointing to letter E, meaning empty. So, for the first time in your life, bibili ka ng gasolina. Imagine yan, bibili ka na ng gasolina mo. Dati binibili mo lang bus ticket, MRT ticket, LRT ticket. Ngayon, gasolina. Dapat rinirecord mo sa diary mo yan. Alam mo, nagbabawal ang buhay mo ngayon. Masyasyak ka na ngayon, masyasyak ka na. Because before, you go to Makati, if you have 50 pesos, back and forth na sa MRT yan. Ngayon, 50 pesos, isang litro pa lang yan. Isang litro pa lang. Hanggang welcome rotunda lang yun. At talagang sobra ng palang gasolina natin ngayon. It is not affordable anymore. Masyado ng mahal. So, you stop in front of the gasoline pump. You call the gasoline boy. We are so excited. Boy! Full tank! Come on, full tank! Siyempre, full tank mo. First time mong bumili gasolina. Dapat yung full tank mo. Yan. Pero bago buti mo yung full tank, yan tingnan mo yung pera mo. Makakala mo yung full tank, piso lang yan. 1,000, di pa mabubull tank yan. Yan. Okay, fill her up. Come on. Okay. Puntak. Lumapit ang boy. Ma'am, anong klaseng gasolina ang nilalagay ko? Yan. Bakit? Maraming mga klaseng gasolina. Siyempre, hindi mo, bagong experience siya, ha? Matalagyan mo lang gasolina. Ano nga ang klaseng gasolina? O, pero ano pinakamabili gasolina yun? At sa mga ginang nakapareho nyo, so gasol ang palagi nyo pinagawa. Pwede na ba yan? So you should do the different kinds of fuel. Okay? We have ordinary gasoline, special gasoline, unleaded, blue gasoline, diesel, kerosene. So, if your car is a gasoline fed engine, you can use ordinary, special, or unleaded. If your car is a diesel engine, of course, you have to use diesel oil. Here comes the gasoline point. Ma'am, ordinary ba o special? Sa'yo. Siyempre, dahil bago ko pa lang natutong mag-drive, hindi mo ko kapisado yan. At tayo mo nang maalat ng bago ka lang natuto. So, ano ba yung sasabihin ko nito? Ordinary or special? Sometimes you use common sense. Since I'm just driving an ordinary owner type Jeep, ordinary. Since you are driving a brand new Corolla, special. Akala mo tumama ka na. Now first, lahat ba ng gasoline fed engine can be run by using ordinary gasoline? Or there are vehicles, although they are gasoline fed, they cannot be run unless you use special gasoline. All gasoline fed engine can be run by using ordinary gasoline. If that is true, how come everybody is using special gasoline? So first, you should know the difference between these two. The main difference between ordinary and special gasoline is the number of octane. Ordinary gasoline has low octane gasoline. Special has high octane gasoline. How do you know if you need high octane or low octane gasoline? Considering this is your first time to drive this car. and you have to experience about this. If your car is brand new, at the right portion is when you get inside the car, at the right portion, there's a glove compartment. You open the compartment, there's a small booklet there. We call that book manual, service manual, wherein all your car specifications are printed in that manual for your guidance. Unfortunately, all our car manufacturers are multinational companies. And to save on printing expenses, they just use one booklet all over the world. And every country has its own term as far as gasoline is concerned. In the United States, the term they use there is leaded or unleaded gasoline. Even if you happen to be in Hong Kong, observe, the term they use there is leaded or unleaded gasoline. It's only in the Philippines that every gas station has its own term, nalilituka. In one station, ang nakikita mo pangalan, ordinary, special. Sa kabila, ordinary, horror. Sa kabila, ordinary, extra. Ordinary, premium. Sa kabila naman, silver. Sa kabila, gold. Yung kabila naman, vortex. Nalilito ka ngayon. Ano ba yung mga silver? Ano ba mahal? Silver o gold? Siyempre, mas malang gold. Kaya nga gold yan eh. Yan. Siyempre, ano ba pagkakaiba nila? Yan. Now, these are just for promotional purposes. Regardless of the term they use for advertisement, gold, silver, vortex, premium, extra. What's more important is the number of octane. What is your specification? You need how many octane? Nakalagay, you need 80 octane gasoline. That is your minimum octane requirement. Which one is 80 octane? Under the Philippine standard, meaning that is the office of the government giving standard to any product sold in the Philippine market. If I'm not mistaken, our present rating for ordinary now is from 75 to 85 octane. Special, from 85 to 95 octane. Your car needs 80 octane. Which of the two are you going to use? Well, you see, ordinary gasoline is more than enough for your octane requirement. So why pay more for the price of a special where ordinary is more than enough? So you can just settle with ordinary gasoline. However, if your car needs 90 octane, then you cannot use ordinary gasoline anymore because the maximum octane for ordinary is only 85, while you need 90 octane, which is within the range of special gasoline. At present, all our late model and brand new cars are now using high octane gasoline. It's only the old cars made in the 1960s, 70s, up to the early 80s that are still using ordinary gasoline. Kaya, if you are not sure about your octane requirement, for the first time, please say, use special gasoline or high-octane gasoline. Kaya nga, in Metro Manila, most gas stations do not sell ordinary gas anymore because there is no more market for this. It's only in the provinces where ordinary gasoline is still available because of these motorized pump cars, tricycles, big machineries, old trucks and buses. Even the government is now planning to phase out ordinary gasoline. It is not viable anymore. So, pag hindi ka sigurado, high-octane gasoline ang bibilin mo. But these are just some of the many problems that you will experience the moment you become a car owner. You know, as I always emphasize, owning a car is not that easy. There's a big responsibility. And every day that you go to the gas station, it is not easy to deal with the gas station. Because, to tell you frankly, most gas stations are cheating the public. Unless you know their techniques, every day that you go there, you are being cheated. So you have to be careful with these. The choice of ordinary special, that is not the problem. The problem is the stage on. How do they cheat the public? Normally, there are three pumps in the station. Ordinary, special, decent, or kaya athletic. At night, when the delivery truck arrives, putting gasoline inside the underground tank, they will put ordinary gasoline inside the special pump. So what is inside this pump is just ordinary gasoline. Since you are using the special pump, the price for the price of a special pump, you are buying, you are paying for the price of a special gasoline, and yet you are only receiving ordinary gasoline. In the provinces, karamihan yan ginagamit nila, ginagawa nila yan. If you are an experienced driver, knowing the sound of your engine, knowing the speed, the performance of your car, as soon as you leave the gasoline station, you can feel it immediately. Something is wrong with the gasoline. You receive a mixture. It is not pure, a special gasoline. A mixture of maybe 50-50 ordinary, 50% special. All condition that you know your car. But in your case, you are just a new driver. Anong alam mo dyan? Siguro kahit na tubig ang nilagay nila sa tangki. Gayun, panyo ng panyo. Jet ng jet ang kotse mo. Talagang hindi pa ako talaga marunong. Kasalan ang dagan na socialite siya. Pagbibintangan mo pa kami dahil ang jet ang kotse mo. What you receive a mixture of water. Next, technique. Every morning, the normal routine of an ordinary person, if your budget is limited, you always buy gasoline daily. Instead of buying it weekly, full tank, commission, in a budget we have, so early morning, before you go to the office, you will stop at this gas station to buy gasoline. Here comes the gasoline boy. Ilang liter of? Oh, you give me, give me 10 liters. 10 liters. So, gagawin niya. For every 10 liters that you buy, you only receive 9 liters. Because of defective calibration. So, if you buy 30 liters, you are only receiving 27 liters. Maputin, 1 liter lang nawawala. Ha? Magkano isang 1 liter dyan? 30 plus pesos na yan. So, pag nawala ka ng 3 liters, that's more than 100 pesos. Why? Because of defective calibration. You know, this is the fault of the government. They are supposed to monitor monthly this gas station. Under the law, all gas stations are required by law to calibrate all the stock and these meters daily basis, araw-araw yan. How do they calibrate? When they open the station every morning, before they open every pump to the public, the gasoline manager is supposed to check on this pump. How? Isisiro niya lahat yan. Isisiro lahat yan. And then, they have this 1 liter, government required 1 liter container, plastic container 1 liter. Iaano niya sa 1 liter, pipras niya 1 liter. Pupunin niya nila ng 1 liter ito. Pag napuno ng 1 liter container, at 1 liter ang lumalabas doon, it is understood, every 1 liter showing there, the customer is receiving 1 liter worth of gasoline. Tama ang meter na yan. Ngayon, kung nagwa 1 liter na rito, half liter pa lang dito sa container, pero lumalabas doon 1 liter, so for every 1 liter showing there, the customer is only receiving half liter. So if you buy 20 liters, you only receive 10 liters. Defective meter, yeah, they are not supposed to open that to the public. They have to seal that defective meter. And immediately they have to report that to the government agency, PNOC. The only agency authorized by the government to open all this pump, to run, to check, to calibrate whether they are not defective or not. Alam mo yung mga pump ng station, parang miracle meter yan eh. Ang miracle meter, you cannot open that. Bawal yan. Yung mga nawasang pumukulot, hindi pwede, nakasil dyan. Mga taxi meter, kahit yung mga taxi, every year, tinitest yan ng LTO, sinesell nyo yan. Pag na-check nyo yan, at naputol yung wire na yan, ay, ibig sabihin na, tamper dyan, hindi, ganun din ito. But do you think the owner will report that? Kung isang taon nilang ginagawa yan sa mga pagkakot, ilang milyon monthly ang nawawala sa customer. Ha? Eh, pero hindi ginagawa ng gobyerno yan. They pressure, they are all honest, they are not. Next. Every morning, you go to the station to buy gasoline. Unfortunately, you are the second car to arrive. The first car purchased 10 liters. After paying the full amount, 10 liters, you are the next car to be served now. Tatanoy ka, ma'am, ilang liters, so? Oh, give me 20 liters. Pang narinig yan 20 liters, he will cover the pump from your tube. Immediately, bumabama na agad yan. Instead of putting back to zero, itutuloy niya, may 10 liters na ron. Oh, pag nag 20 liters na, ma'am, 20 liters na ron. You pay for the price of 20 liters, but you only receive 10 liters. Pinayaran na nung isang kotse, napunta sa kanya, may nabahit pa sa iyo. Lahat ginagawa nila yan. Lahat ng istasyon. Of course, this is not the job of the owner. If you are the owner of the business, knowingly, you will not cheat your customers. This is the job of the employees. The gasoline boy in connivance with the gasoline engineer. At the end of the day, here comes the gasoline owner. Pupunin niya lahat ang pera. And then, he will make an accounting. The number of liters sold. And then the excess. Siyempre may sobrang pera dyan. And the excess money will be distributed among them there. Kaya dapat, when you go to the station, kailangan mag-tinitingnan mo yung pump. Kasi under the law, they have a warning sign. May mga warning sign yan eh. Warning to all customers, please check whether the pump starts from zero. Pero yan, nakasin yan. But even without that sign, they are supposed to remind you, ma'am, zero na ho, dapat ba, zero na ho. Dapat sinasabi nila yon. Pero pag gusto nila mandaya, hindi nila sasabihin sa'yo. Pag kukunin ka nila sa bilisan, lalo ng mga babae, hindi naman bumabay mo bayo sa kotse. Oh, 20 liter, mag-detect ka. Mag-detect mo yan, alis ka na. So, patay ka ngayon. But you can feel it. Kung isa baka alata ka, pumikit ka lang, 10 na. Pumikit lang ako lahat. Sobrang. Yan, basta kinabang ka, nagdaya ka. Do not give them that opportunity. So be sure, before they start pumping, check mo muna yung pump. Okay? Next, unleaded gasoline. This was introduced 15 years ago. Late na nga tayo. Because based on US findings, the lead contents of gasoline is more than enough for human consumption. You know, when you walk in Metro Manila area, yung usok na lumalabas sa tambucho, nagkasalina yan, galing sa kasalina, may lead content dyan. And this lead is cancer-producing chemical. Pag sinisingot mo yung usok na yan, at pumapasok sa katawan mo, pag sumobra na ang lead ng katawan mo, magkakakancer ka. And the first thing that will affect you is your brain. Yan ang ina-affect ng lead, yung brain. So, after several experiments, talagang it is really, talagang totoo, talagang nagkakakancer. So, ginawa nilang unleaded gasoline. In fact, the government even priced unleaded gasoline cheaper than leaded gasoline to encourage everybody to use unleaded gasoline. But at that time, 15 years ago, It was a chat pool explained to the motorists. All drivers, they thought if you are driving an old car, it cannot accept unleaded gasoline. That is not true. Even old cars can accept unleaded gasoline. And when it was explained, it was found out, because it is not only gasoline that is using lead. Halos lahat ng product natin may lead content siya. Yung sardinas, kung saan nakaupo, yung isda, lead yun. Yung store, kung nakabalot yung store na candy, para hindi dumikit ang candy doon sa pamramer, lead yun. So pag kinain mong store, kumakain ka ng lead. Nung nalaman ng mga tao, yung store pala may lead. So bumaba ang sale ng store. So the joke at the time, when you go to the sari-sari store, pabili nga mo ng store, ano, leaded or unleaded? So ibig sabihin, alam nila, pag leaded, hindi na bibili ng tao yan. So at least, you know, people are now conscious about the product that they are buying. Kaya ngayon, the moment you are in Metro Manila, where unleaded gasoline is available, please use unleaded gasoline. It is not only cheaper, but at the same time, for every single drop of gasoline that you are buying unleaded, you are not only helping yourself, but at the same time, you are helping the environment. We have to clean the air in the Metro Manila area. And if you, that's the only contribution that you can do, please use unleaded gasoline. Now, if you happen to be in remote provinces in which unleaded gasoline is not available, you can always shift to leaded gasoline. Ano ba yung leaded? Yan. Itong premium, special, oron, extra, o kaya gold, mga leaded yan. Leaded gasoline. Ngayon. Next, blue gasoline. This is the gasoline for airplanes. Or we call it aviation gas. Aviation gas. Suppose you are a pilot coming from the airport, sumalo ka ng 2 galon ng blue gasoline sa 747 jetliner mo. Inuwi mo sa bahay yan. Pagdating sa bahay, nilagay mo sa Corolla mo. In-start mo, lumipad. Pumunta ng buong Singapore yan. Ililipad ba yan? It will not. You will damage your car. Because this is high-octane gasoline. Kaya nga blue gasoline. The minimum octane for this is 115 octane. Yeah. This is not available outside the airport. This is special mix, expensive kind of gasoline. You can only buy this inside the airport. Kaya nga pag sumasakit tayo ng tamo, masyadong mahal. This is talagang mahal ang fuel na aviation gas na yan. Kaya nga by just looking at the color of the gasoline, you can easily determine whether you use ordinary or special gasoline. What is the color for ordinary gasoline? Reddish in color. Mapula-pula pag ordinary. Special gasoline, bluish in color. Blue gasoline is practically blue in color due to high octane rating. You know, to explain in a simple way, octane is like coffee. Let's say there's a dead person in your place at night during the week. Ang dami nakikilamay. Nagtotongis, nagtotongino, nakikilamay. And it's a tradition, if everybody's dead, you sell coffee. Pero mahirap lang na mataya. 10 piso pa lang ang abuloy. 100 ang nakikilamay. So you boil 1 drum of water, bibili kang 1 sachet na kape sa 10 piso, ipapagpagpusap. Halos hindi nagkulay, para sa labat yan. But everybody can be accommodated the whole night. Kung nagtotongis ka, she's init na lang, pero halos tubig yan eh. Matamang. But everybody can be accommodated. Pero bigyan mong tao, tasa ng tubig, siyang magsasangkap, tatapangan niya ng kape, ang itim. Out of this one is kape bottle, you can only serve that person. So the moment you lower the number of octane, you can produce more gasoline. Kaya in 1970s, we were under martial law, and there was gasoline crisis pila-pila sa estasyon. The government, without informing the public, lower the number of octane. Because if you lower the number of octane, you can produce more gasoline. So everybody can be accommodated. They did that for several days. But that's only temporary situation. After that, they have to return it back to each unit original safe rating. Because if you keep on doing that for long, mawawasak lahat ng makina, kakatok lahat siya. That is blue gasoline. Next, he said, of course, if your car is a diesel engine, you have to use diesel oil. But we have a problem here. Because of the big difference in price between diesel and gasoline, maraming tao may nagsisip na sa diesel to save on gasoline expense. Unfortunately, diesel is only a byproduct of gasoline. To produce diesel, you have to manufacture gasoline. And there's an oversupply of gasoline, and yet there's a short supply of diesel. We have to import diesel, and we have to export gasoline. If the trend will continue, pag nag-reverse na ang sitwasyon, marami ng diesel kesa sa gasolina, magkakaproblema tayo sa supply na niya. Diesel. If your car is a diesel engine, you have to be extra careful again. Especially when you go to the station. Why? Because when you go to the station, you are not dealing with professionals. Not like when you go to any bank, any government office, any private office there. Every person seated in that office table entertaining you is highly educated. But when you go to the stations, you are not dealing with professionals. You are dealing with ordinary boys, gasoline boys. Kumisan, they are not highly trained. They are not highly educated. Kumisan, bagong salta sa Manila. Galing sa probinsya, naghahanap ng trabaho. Wanted gasoline boy. Nag-apply siya. Linagyan siya ng t-shirt. Boy na siya. Eh, di man marunong sa kotse yan. Ni tricycle, hindi pa nakasakay yan. Tapos, Mercedes-Benz sa kotse mo, siya nag-aasikas sa kotse mo. Ah, magkakaproblema dyan. In 1960s, every morning, nagkakabarilan sa estasyon, nagkakasuntukan. Palagi yan, every morning, magkakabarilan sa estasyon, basta bago ang boy. Why? At that time, the more popular car was the Volkswagen Beetle. 16. Lahat ng tao na yun, Beetle, lahat ng Beetle. Bagong boy, dumating ang customer ngayon. Boy, check mo lahat yan, check mo lahat. Pupunta na sa CR yung kuwan, magkocopy na doon sa coffee shop dyan. So, binigay mo ito sulit, check mo lahat. Bubuksan ang boot. Siyempre, ang Toyota, pag binuksan mo yun, yung nasa rapat, radiator. Binuksan ako. So, binuusan lang yung tubig niya. Naka-limang baldi na, hindi pa napukulong. Kasi radiator, dapat konti lang puno yan. Ito, limang baldi na, hindi pa napukulong. Tapos, dumating may reser, puno na akong radiator. Anong radiator? Gasoline tank po yan. Ang Volkswagen kasi gasoline tank na sarapan.